definition.
Police say two boys are the victims of sexual solicitation from another child, and we've learned this is proof of a growing trend. Good evening, everyone. I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Michael Cogdill. That case didn't stop with solicitation, and because of that, a 12-year-old faces a serious charge.
News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local from our Spartanburg newsroom tonight. Mike, what's the charge?
Well, Carol and Michael, it is criminal sexual conduct, and experts say this case should serve as an eye-opener to parents who think adults are the only ones preying on their children.
Be guarded, be extra protective.
Joe Gramling Lopez is the executive director of the Children's Advocacy Center of Spartanburg.
We see younger and younger predators.
She says in the last few months they've seen an uptick in the number of cases involving children who prey on other children. Police and union are dealing with one now. According to an incident report, a 12-year-old boy asked two other boys, ages 4 and 7, to go behind a rec center building with him in this neighborhood park. Police say the 12-year-old boy exposed himself and then got one of the boys to perform a sex act on him twice by offering to let him ride his bike. According to the report, the 12-year-old also tried to get the boys to perform a sex act on each other, but they wouldn't. We don't know about the 12-year-old's past, but Gramling Lopez says in general, some child predators were victims themselves and others are acting out what they've seen.
We have lots of children who witness firsthand their parents engaging in sexual activity.
She says parents should teach their children what kind of touch is okay and what kind isn't. And if a child starts to act out sexually, develops fears or nightmares, it's possible they've become a victim.
Always believe what your child says and talk it through.
And that incident there in Union happened between the end of May and the beginning of June. Police have been investigating ever since, and that led to the arrest of the 12-year-old late last week. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.